बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, रब्बे ज़िदनी इल्मा, रब्बे ज़िदनी इल्मा, रब्बे ज़िदनी इल्मा। टुडे वी विल लर्न व्हाट इज द कैलकुलेशन मेथड बीइंग डन बाय द बैंकिंग इंडस्ट्री फॉर मीटिंग द बिजनेस नीड ऑफ देयर कस्टमर्स। सो एज वी ऑल नो दैट वर्किंग कैपिटल इज द अमाउंट ऑफ फंड्स द कंपनी हैज फॉर मीटिंग द डेली एक्टिविटीज ऑफ द बिजनेसेस और द ऑपरेशनल एक्टिविटीज ऑफ द बिजनेसेस। इट इज अ फाइनेंशियल मैट्रिक्स दैट मेजर्स द कंपनीज लिक्विडिटी पोजीशंस। Sometimes what happens, the company needs more fund. It is due to the increased cost of doing their business, and for this they need to avail the creditors either from internal financing or the external financing. Let's say for instance the company has put up a request of 50 million. It is just a hypothetical figure, and they put up the request to the banking industry for meeting their working capital requirements. So in this case the bank will obtain so many documents. Among them, financial statements will be key document through which they will try to ascertain what is the financial performance of the company. In terms of financial performance, in terms of they will try to see what is the sale, what is the profitability of the company, what are the current assets. In current assets, they will observe what is the inventory, what is the account receivables position, and what is the accounts payable positions. And this will be the main figures they will try to take up, and they will try to take the calculation of cash conversion cycle days, and they will decide how much of amount should be given to their customer who has put up the request for meeting their business needs. So in this topic today we will learn how the working capital requirements is being calculated by the banking industry. Before discussing formula, let's see what are the main points that we must have in our mind. First point would be, as working capital has a key place in the field of finance. No doubt it is a greater importance in the theory of finance, and the efficient use of it has a direct impact on the profit of the company. The third point is, the survival of business will be impossible if there is no proper management of the working capital. It is therefore necessary to provide the constant supply of the working capital to the business for meeting the daily activities or the basic operation of businesses. The simple definition you people already have in your mind, that is the difference between the current assets minus current liabilities. It is also known as net working capital. And these are three additional points that you must have in your mind, that without proper management of working capital, the businesses cannot run in longer run. It is therefore necessary that there must be efficient use of the working capital management. Now let's see the next slide, how the banking industry practically calculate the working capital needs of their customer. The formula is simple, and you are watching on your slides. The formula for calculating working capital requirement of business is, the banking does simply, they take the cost of goods sold from the financial statement, then they divide this figure with the number of days in a year. Most of the times they take 360 days and multiply it with the number of days of cash conversion cycle. The formula of cash conversion cycle is simple. It's all about the DSO plus DIO minus DPO. DSO stands for the days sale outstanding, DIO stands for the days inventory outstanding, and DPO stands for the days payable outstanding. Now this is a simple formula through which, with the support of this, the banking industry decide what amount should be given to their customer in the shape of working capital. So here in the next slide you are watching, these are the actual hypothetical figure. We are just assuming the cost of goods of the customer is 550 million. Number of days in a year that we have just discussed, this is the 360 days. And days in cash conversion cycle, again, this is a hypothetical figure of 30 days. The banking industry, what will they do? They will simply take the cost of goods sold and they divide it with the 360 days. And finally, this figure with the number of days in a cash conversion cycle, the amount that comes is equivalent to the 45,840,000. This is the actually working capital will be approved by the banking industry in favor of their customer for meeting the working capital requirement of the business. That is 45,840,000 against the request of the 50 million that we just discussed. The customer has put up the request of 50 million to the banking industry, but what banking industry has done here is that, with the support of this formula, the amount that comes with the support of this formula, they will try to approve it and will confer this amount to their desired borrower in order to meet their customer's needs. And customer can obtain this amount from the banking industry if they are satisfied with this type of amount. 45 million it and 40 million thousand. Hope so, guys, you have understand now how the banking industries practically calculate the working capital requirements of the different customers, businesses, and different business models. And this is actually simple formula. Again, I am repeating, they take the cost of goods sold, then they divide this cost of goods sold with the number of days in a year. And finally, the amount that comes, they multiply with the cash conversion cycle. Whatever amount comes, they simply approve it in the favor of those customers who have put the request to the banking industry for meeting their daily needs or the liquidity position that they have. Thanks, guys. Hope so you enjoyed a lot. You understood how the banking industry calculate the working capital requirements of the different borrowers. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.